It's almost 10 o'clock in the morning. Trying to see what temperature it is out here. Because on my computer, it says it's minus 2 right now. But if I take a thermometer out here, I don't know if you can see that. Anyways, it says 41.7 Fahrenheit, or 5 degrees, almost 6 degrees Celsius. So I'm gonna go see. Hey buddy. Oh, there's a squirrel wanting his peanuts. I'm gonna go see what it's like. In the tent. I'm gonna go see if the candle's still burning. And there's a lot of snow on top. So I'll wait. Yeah, it's a lot of snow, eh? So what I can do with this, those meat thermometers, I could just push it right through the material. 3.5 degrees Celsius, 38 degrees. All right. Okay, so that worked. I'm gonna check if that candle's still on. I'll be back. I have to take this off carefully because I don't want it to break any branches. Hey, how you doing in there? You want some sunshine? There's a blossom. Okay. All right, so here we are. I know this one stayed warm. So maybe some of them on the outskirts might not have. I think these ones are good, but that one over there, I think I lost this one. And that one down there, I think it's just too close to the blanket. Not sure about this one. There's one there. There's a bunch there. I don't know. I can't keep it under the tent all day. It's got to have sunshine. And this is dark material. So, you know, is it worth the effort? Well, we'll see. You know, it's just going to be 2 nights of doing this. And the candle went out. You can tell because when I touched on top, that's cold. Ooh, look at that. City. So there's the update. 4 blossoms so far on the ground. And, you know, this was my problem here too. See, the post wasn't, I didn't have this out enough, and this part covered enough. So I think what we're gonna do tonight, it was already snowing when we were doing this, and it was like a quick fix, and yeah, I'm gonna grab other posts and see what we could do tonight. And it's supposed to get really cold, so I may include some bubble wrap. I'm not sure. It's just so disheartening when you see this happening. There we go. All right, so I've got 4 posts, well, 3 posts in the ladder. I got some bubble wrap inside. I think what I'll do is see how far that goes and wrap the exterior, the lower part, with bubble wrap, and then see if I could get the sheets to go on top. Because the wind chill is supposed to be really cold tonight, like -4. And if that gets to -2 under here, these blossoms are gone. And I already lost a bunch, so I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, possibly 10 blossoms left. I think all the rest are gone. All these little guys hanging on. Can only do the best we can do. Alright, here's the peach tree tent from last night. We had some bubble wrap around the midsection and we wrapped everything up. Got a little wider. Bubble wrap. It was supposed to reach -7 last night, and then it got windy, so I have no idea what happened in there, what the temps were. I thought last night was going to be the last night that we'd have to do this, but tonight's supposed to be -3. So I don't know, but it needs its sunlight right now, and it's warm enough. It's 38 degrees out here right now, or almost 4 degrees Celsius. So I have to take this off. We'll see. Okay, here I am under the tent. All these blossoms. Well, actually, they still look pretty nice. You don't know, though, until whether they fall off or not. I still have a candle burning. That one out. That one's out. This one's up there. Anyways, I'm gonna need some help getting this top part off, so I don't want it to fall on the top of the tree. So I think I'm gonna leave this stuff out here for one more night. So I'm just gonna take the top off so that it gets the sunshine. So this is after the coldest night, so I don't know. The experiment goes on. As for the lettuce, it's doing great. The spinach, even the seedlings that have come up. Alright, it's night number three. So the first night was supposed to be -2 or 3 or something like that. It was supposed to be really cold. That was the first night it was snowing, and I did the first video. Last night though, -7 and -11 with wind chill. So we really wrapped the tree up last night, and I had 2 candles underneath it. Tonight is -2. So looking at the tree here, it was windy too. The winds died down. I guess it's just fooling around. Hold on. Okay, so here we go. So we did lose blossoms, but I'm not sure if that was just because there's still many left. Because the fabric was on top, and I think it just basically rubbed them off the ends here. But I mean, we still have blossoms up here, blossoms there. I don't know, those ones might be gone over there, too close to the sheet. Another one down here. Okay. So what I'm thinking is, what was I thinking? Oh, temperature. Let's look at the temperature. 40 Fahrenheit. Alright, so hopefully the wind doesn't pick up. I'm going to be putting another candle under there. That should last a long time. It's actually candles I used to make, and I know they're 45-hour candles, so it should last the whole night in there. And I'm going to wrap this up. So this is night 3, and should be the last night that we have to do this. I thought last night was, but now all of a sudden, cold temperatures again tonight. So here we go. Okay, here's the setup. Literally wrapped up. It's got the top. It's all wrapped up. We've got, you can actually see through here. That candle's not going to last too much longer. That's a citronella candle in a can. And then I got the other one under the... won't be able to see that. I have the other one under the pot, the clay pot. Anyways, that's it. Hopefully we get a few peaches this year. It'll be well worth the work if we get a few peaches that actually mature to nice fruit this year. That's why you got a peach tree. So, crazy weather. Just too cold after being too warm. Maybe I should look into getting a peach tree that doesn't flower until later. Yeah, something to think about. See you later. It did freeze last night. Well, we took the cover off the peach tree, and so the candles worked really well for warmth. However, there is soot everywhere, all inside the sheets, and everything was all black. I had to go wash my hands. So I'm not really how good that was for the tree, but blossoms, 1, 2 there, 3, 4. I'm documenting this, so 5, 6. Eleven, 12, and 13. So, 13 blossoms left. Hopefully, one of these, or a couple of these, or a few of these, turn into peaches. I'm not sure. That soot might have just done them in. Carry on, young peach tree. You survived. So far, so good.